Oh yes. Now I have done quite a few codes that swap the signposts with, another object. Because signposts, there's quite a few of them in a lot of the levels, so it's very handy to mesh change all those objects. So let's do that. Now we need to go to Snowman's Land and Cool Cool Mountain. Well, we can't physically go to both of them at the same time. So what should we start with, Mario? You lead the way. Oh, you're going for Cool Cool Mountain, is that Mario? Oh, I don't speak then. Oh, wait, you can't. Any star? Yes, any star. It's the big ice bully, but no, some of the other big ice bullies have been destroyed, and look, loads of stars. Yes, stop pushing me around. How would you like being pushed around? Yeah, you heard that. You don't like that, do you? You don't like being pushed, do you? Yes, you like. Oh no, you like that. You like that, don't you? Yeah, you're back for more. And see, there's another one there. Now let's, before Mario gets seriously beaten up, if I can exit. Well, it's not exit anymore, it's in German. Whatever exit is in German. Let's go to Snowman's Land. Now, you all must remember how to get to Snowman's Land. What? You don't remember how to get to Snowman's Land? Oh, shame on you. Well, I'll give you a clue. You need to look at your reflection to get to Snowman's Land. And then take a left. Here we go. Into the wall. So, again, any star that you want. Immediately, more stars appear because the big ice bullies have been destroyed. Now, let's go to where the original one is. You should see he's still there. See, with all the other stars from the other big ice bullies. See? And then if we go to, there's another one. Come on, Mario, stop slip sliding away. Another one's been destroyed because the game must realize, oh wait, it's in the wrong place. Mario needs to get the star. Right, and that just leaves with one more thing. What I started to tell you about at the start of the video is this strange, well, when I say strange, sorry Germans, because that seem to use it. So yeah, let me just call this up then. Let's go to the address. Now this is only in the PAL game, however I'll expand upon that in a moment because it is sort of in the NTSC ROM as well, sort of. Remember that the NTSC ROM has a lot of the colourful characters missing. Right, if I set this to 1, see that U-like character appears to the right of the screen. Let me just get a better contrast on that. Now you can increase this value up to 6, and 6 of them will appear anymore, and it'll just go off the screen. Then you'll go, oh, what is the point of that? That's like the oldest thing ever. Well, I'll get to that. Now, the U character is not in the NTSC ROM, it's not there. However, I've checked using an emulator and the coding and the variable is still there. So my reasoning is it's an unused feature and that U-like character only appears because the real character isn't there. So you might be thinking, what were Nintendo planning to use this for? Well, let's look at the facts. It shows from 1 to 6 of the same symbol, okay? Think about it. Right, there's 8 red coins, but they might have had 6 originally. Oh, yes, just throw in a few more red coins, make it a bit harder. Or it could be anything else. The symbol's not there, but what could it have been? Nintendo might have realised, oh, well, that obstructs the display a bit. Let's move the red coins to when you pause. Oh, and it animates them. Now, I don't know if you'll be able to see this on this low resolution recording, but if you can see that, it says time, temps and zeet. Time is obviously time in English. Oh really? And temps is the French for time, or at least that's what Nintendo thinks. And zeet is the German for time, yeah. Now at the top we have a percent and D, which people who are into programming might recognise as a C star string. Then we have 2F and the forward slash. That is what translates to the U character. Now this is ASCII. So if I change this value to 2A, we get the crosses like from the lives and the stars. If we then change it to 2B, we get the coins. See? Ooh, coins. And 2C, we get the Mario heads. And lastly, 2D, we get the stars. So you see, this could have been used for basically anything with the right symbol to display something. Perhaps when you get hidden stars or something to activate something, but perhaps Nintendo just thought, you know, that it just got in the way of display too much and moved things like the red coins to the pause screen. What this does mean, however, even if we will never know what it was to be used for, is that it could be used for something else in a code to display something. You have to modify the code in that. There's possibilities that I'm looking into. Well, that's about it for now. Thank you for viewing, and thank you for those who comment, rate and subscribe. And that's bye for now. Bye.